SCP-173 Incident Report. Date, 7/23/1997. On the morning of July 23, 1997, a serious breach of security occurred at SCP Site-19. A significant loss of life was experienced. At approximately 2:45 a.m., security monitors showed an empty cell that was supposed to contain SCP-173. Moving the cameras did nothing to reveal SCP-173, hiding in a corner or some such thing. It was not in the cell. Subsequent review of the video showed that the camera switched off for approximately 10 seconds, an occurrence that went unnoticed by the techs on hand. A team was dispatched to the cell and the door was found to be unlocked and open. The door looked to be undamaged in any way. Video feeds from the entire facility were viewed immediately, and bodies of various lab personnel were found in corridors leading away from the cell. Each person looked to have been strangled or had their necks snapped, which was the common method of attack employed by SCP-173. Following the trail of bodies, it soon became apparent that SCP-173 was attempting to flee the facility. It is unclear at this time how SCP-173 knew the route to the exit. Once the security team reached the exit used by SCP-173, they encountered two more bodies of lab personnel in the parking lot, as well as the body of the guard in the booth at the entrance to the facility. One thing became clear immediately. All those killed were alone at the time in the area where they were killed. Apparently, there was no chance of one person being attacked and another person witnessing the attack. If that had been the case, SCP-173 would have been rendered immobile due to being in the line of sight of that witness. What was not clear was how SCP-173 was able to move undetected by even one person. One theory put forth was that SCP-173 was able to determine when a person had their back to it, and it could move freely and swiftly, coming up behind their victims and attacking them. If this theory proves accurate, it would mean SCP-173 has the intelligence to move with stealth and knows it must move unobserved. The security team followed what appeared to be tracks left by SCP-173, but the tracks were soon lost in the undergrowth of the surrounding jungle. The security team returned to the facility and acquired vehicles in preparation of pursuing SCP-173. Being alone in the jungle, the entity would be able to move at great speed without anyone to witness its movement. The leader of the security team was under the impression that SCP-173 was heading toward population. There is a town of approximately 30,000 people, about 6 miles south of the facility. Many of the techs at the lab were terrified of what SCP-173 could do if it reached the town. The answer to that question came about 20 minutes later, when a phone call was received at the lab. A lab tech was calling from the town, saying that SCP-173 was standing in a tavern on the outskirts of town. The lab tech and his girlfriend had gone to the tavern for the evening and were there for approximately 10 minutes when the doors to the establishment were knocked off their hinges. The doors flew into the establishment with such force that one of them struck a man in the head, killing him instantly. When the dust cleared, the lab tech saw SCP-173 standing in the doorway. It was being held immobile by a number of tavern occupants, who were just staring at the statue. Tech yelled at everyone to keep their eyes on SCP-173 and not to look away or even blink. Though this warning was correctly given by the tech, no one in the tavern knew what SCP-173 was capable of, and they all looked at the tech, wondering what he was talking about. Before the tech could get his own eyes back on SCP-173, it had killed 3 more people. The tech told everyone to stand in a circle around the entity and stare at it. He told them that would keep it immobile. No one believed that was true, but no one was willing to take the risk. For the next 20 minutes, SCP-173 was held captive by the stares of 15 people, while the tech was able to call the lab and report what was happening. Actually, when he called, his report sounded more like, "What the F is SCP-173 doing in a bar in town?" The security team was alerted and on the scene within 10 minutes, relieving 15 very tired, dry-eyed civilians from their staring contest with the concrete entity. A containment unit was on scene within 20 minutes, and SCP-173 was placed inside it and removed from the tavern. After returning SCP-173 to the facility and its holding cell, an investigation was launched into how it got out in the first place. A complete lockdown was instituted on the facility, and each room was searched for clues. At this time, there is no evidence pointing to the guilty party or parties. Addendum. About 5 hours after the incident was concluded, two lab techs found SCP-131-B cowering in a corner of the cafeteria, underneath a rack of dishes. It was apparently frightened about something, and any attempts to get it to reveal the cause of its fears have been unsuccessful. Also of note, the whereabouts of SCP-131-A can't be ascertained at this time. A search of the facility is ongoing.